live across North Texas and beyond. This is the Jenna Ryan Show. Ain't that America for you and me? Ain't that America? Little pretty houses for you. Jenna Ryan is a world-renowned speaker and thought leader, ranked in the 87th most influential person online by Fast Company magazine. Jenna Ryan has spoken to thousands around the world and is now speaking to you. So with all things real estate and beyond, here is Jenna Ryan.
Hello, everybody. What is up? Welcome to the show this beautiful Sunday here across the North Dallas Metroplex.
And Barry, tell me a little bit about yourself. Here's Barry, everybody, on Facebook.
Hi, everyone. I'm a custom home builder. I started building in 1979, so I've got a few years under my belt.
Yeah.
But we build the luxury move-up market. So my typical buyer has owned three or four homes in their life, and now they're ready for something truly custom.
All right. So we're talking, you do all the bells and whistles, the fancy-smancy stuff in Starwood. And
We build in the up-and-coming neighborhoods. We like to say that we never say no to anything. The yes may include a few dollar signs after it, but there's always a yes involved.
I like it. I like that philosophy. That sounds good. So we're going to get some great information today. So now, Phil, let's talk about the membership there at the Home Builders Association. Are all the home builders in the association?
Pretty much, our estimation is that we represent about 90% of the home building market. 24 out of the top 30 builders that are out there, that'll range anywhere from the upper-end custom builders like Barry over here all the way up to the large volume builders like Kayovanian, Pulte, Dries. A lot of those are very actively involved as well.
Right. And I looked at your newsletter and your website and really researched a lot about you guys. And y'all do a lot of things for home builders. You provide the McSam Award for Home Builder of the Year. Is that correct?
Yeah, and that's McSam's Sales and Marketing Award. So that's the SAM at the end of it. Really get to showcase a lot of the best products that are out there.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, there's awards for like best salesperson, best print ad, best. But you'll also do the Home Builder of the Year, right?
Definitely. Yeah, we do that for McSam and then also our ARC Awards later on this year. So those are for our custom builders and remodelers.
Okay, so there's different levels of options.
Yep.
Now, who won last year?
Trying to remember.
I think I might have it right here.
You may actually have that because I don't even remember what happened last week, let alone what happened last year.
I know. Right there.
All right, who do we have here? So we have American Legend Homes won it last year.
American Legend Homes. I love American Legend Homes.
Yep, and Hillwood got Developer of the Year.
Okay. Well, that rocks. So now we know. And then y'all also do a ton of, like, tournaments, golf tournaments all the time,
it seems. Yeah, it's a work hard, play hard type of group. So
right?
A lot of our associate members, obviously, they want to do business with builders. So networking is a really core part of what we do, as well as the advocacy that we do on behalf of the builders.
Right. I can't wait to talk a little bit about that. Okay, now, do you have a lot of realtors that are in the Builder Association?
Yeah, quite a few that actually, especially the ones that specialize in the new home market and the new home building market. Barry, in fact, has done an awful lot of outreach over to the realtor community to try to get them involved and let them know that new home builders don't bite, and they're actually a pretty good group to work with.
We definitely believe that. I don't know any realtor that doesn't love to sell a brand new home. Come on now. We love it.
Oh, absolutely.
We love it. Okay. And so you're involved also, and it looks like you've done some outreach. You do some outreach, and one of them is called Operation Finally Home, which is a charity where you go and you build a home, or the home builders come together and donate with this organization to build a home for a veteran who has been, you know, injured. And that is the sweetest charity.
It's really one of the favorite things that makes me go to work every day is to work for our charity of choice, which is, as you said, Operation Finally Home. They build mortgage-free homes for combat wounded veterans and their families.
Okay. Wow.
And it's an incredible organization to work with because you have these veterans out there that have worked so hard to preserve and protect the American dream, and then here are our members that are able to build the American dream for them. I mean, I just really can't think of anyone who's any more deserving. And these families are just incredible what they've been through, how grateful they are. It moves me every time we get involved in a new project, and we've done five so far.
That is a fabulous thing to do and a good person to do it for. And then they go to the Stars games and present this the family that went, that gets it for that year.
Yeah, we've done, I think we've covered every sports team in the area except for the Cowboys. So if Jerry's listening,
Hey, Jerry.
We'd love to do a love to do a reveal at the Cowboys game maybe sometime this coming season.
Okay, well, I did tweet President Trump and let him know that we're going to be discussing him today on the show. And I figured, hey, you know, he's been known to listen to some shows and he loves listening to stuff. So I thought, well, maybe he will read my tweet. And the reason I want to talk about President Trump is because, according to your website, the Dallas Home Builders Association, it says that acting on a campaign promise made to home builders, President Trump signed an executive order on Tuesday directing the Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to begin to process the process of rescinding and revising the controversial Waters of the United States WOTUS rule.
Yep, and I know there's a lot to that as far as, WOTUS, Waters of the U.S., essentially
what is that?
That was a regulatory overreach that was attempted by the Obama administration, and really what you have on developments is a very expensive, if you have to go through it, federal permitting process for developments if you're developing with a navigable waterway on your development site. Well, what they wanted to do is expand the definition of these waterways to include basically any mud puddle or any sort of, whether it's man-made or natural-made water that would
Seriously?
Be on your yeah that would be on your site, because theoretically it could filter down into a stream, into a river, into the ocean, and it was very unclear as far as how far this could go.
You got to see the shock on my face right now. I can't even believe that. That is crazy.
Yeah, so it was really a tailor-made thing for him to reverse it, and we had been fighting it in the courts for years because there's just a lot of uncertainty out there, and now that's behind us, we certainly have some other challenges, but that was a big one to overcome and a big win for the industry.
Congratulations. And that's the kind of things that the Dallas Builder Association does for the builders. They lobby and fight for these laws, and this is interesting that the Trump administration is really into anti-regulation so that we can build some houses around here.
Yeah, and it was great. I mean, we're a part of the Texas Association of Builders and the National Association of Home Builders. The National Association of Home Builders chairman, Granger McDonald's from Texas, from Kerrville, he was standing right alongside the president when he revoked that executive order.
Was he?
So that was great. I always say in politics, you're either at the table or on the menu, and we were definitely at the table there.
Whoa, did he have the gold curtains behind him?
Yeah, I think he was just right there in the signing room, the Oval Office, and it was really cool.
Heavens.
That didn't happen. That hasn't happened for our industry in a while, so it was great.
Thank
to be
you,
there.
President Trump. We appreciate you doing that and keeping your promise. We're about to go to break, and after the break, Barry is going to come over here, and we're going to talk with him, and he's going to be live on Facebook Live with us. So, you guys, if you have any questions, the phone lines are open, 214-787-1190. Call in. Ask a question of Phil Crone or Barry Hensley with North Star Homes.
Are you thinking of buying or selling a home? If so, contact me, Jenna Ryan, with RE/MAX Dallas Suburbs. I was born and raised in Dallas, and I know every area and every suburb. If you're relocating to the area, downsizing, or upsizing, or buying your first home, I can help you find the home that's perfect for you. Contact me today at 972-510-9177 or go to my website at JennaRyanRealty.com. You can also email me at JennaRyanRealty@gmail.com. Whether you're buying or selling, I'm Jenna Ryan, your best friend in real estate. I have my own radio show, 25 years of sales experience, and a team of experts to help you with all of your real estate needs. Join me, Jenna Ryan, from 11 to 12 on Sundays, where we talk real estate on Talk Radio 1190.
Hi, can I have 2 steak tacos?
Flour or corn?
Oh, no tortillas. And no steak. Also add turkey, lettuce, and tomato. And just put it between 2 slices of bread.
You know this is a taco truck, right?
As a small business owner, you've got enough to deal with. Let the experts at Progressive insure your business so you can focus on whatever that was. With over 30 commercial, auto, and business coverage options, we'll build a plan that's right for you.
Oh, I'll have Swiss on that too. Thank you.
Visit ProgressiveCommercial.com to get started. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Hey there, and good morning. From the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer Weather Center, I'm Will Shawell with a look at your DFW forecast. Showers today in a high around 66, then tonight more showers and a low around 60. This report's brought to you by the TJ Martell Foundation.
Hey everybody, I'm Eric Church, asking you to join me in the fight against leukemia, cancer, and AIDS through the TJ Martell Foundation. Your support helps facilitate cutting-edge research that will lead to more effective treatments and save more lives. Visit tjmartell.org to learn about music's promise for a cure.
Welcome back to the Jenna Ryan Show.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back. We're glad to have you. I'm here today with Barry Hensley of North Star Luxury Homes in Frisco, Texas. We are live on Facebook at Jenna.Ryan1. We also have Phil Crone with the Dallas Builders Association. And we are really getting some great information today. Thank you for listening. The phone lines are open, 214-787-1190. We want to hear from you. We want to hear what you want to know. Let us know what you want to know. We've got some very knowledgeable people here that know probably everything there is to know about building houses and construction in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. So now let's just get right into the content here. So you build homes for North Star Luxury Homes.
I do.
And you're involved from beginning to end.
We start with a piece of dirt.
Okay.
It's very rewarding to think that you can take a piece of dirt and a year later you're handing the keys to someone who's moving into their dream home. That's really why I'm in the building business, because it's a very rewarding thing to do. But we start with a piece of dirt.
Okay.
No pre-approved plans, no book of plans to look through. We literally design everything from the ground up. And if you ask for it, we'll build it for you.
Okay, so you work for like the luxury market, or do you work for every market?
Well, we're capable of working in every market, but there are certain markets that are dominated by certain builders. And, of course, custom builders typically have more of a foothold in the luxury custom end, which is what we build in. So our buyer has owned 3 or 4 homes. We're in the luxury move-up market. We're typically building a 6,000 or 7,000 square foot home for someone.
That's what I thought. And you build in neighborhoods such as Starwood. What are some of the other developments?
We've got a presence in the hills of Kingswood in Frisco.
Yes.
We're in Shattuck Creek Estates in Frisco.
Okay.
We've built in Newman Village, another Frisco development, in Starwood. So we've got, I live in Frisco, built in and around Frisco. We've built in McKinney and Prosper and Richardson and Plano and all the areas on the north side.
And someone from California liked you so well, they're like, I saw it on your website.
What did they say?
It said, I didn't care how far it was. I had to have this company to build our home in California.
Mm-hmm.
So that spoke very highly of you. Oh, we've got a caller.
Yes, this is Nancy. She said she has a question to ask the home builder. She says she has a lot and she's wanting to know how she could bring somebody out if they could build on that lot.
Okay. Hi, hey. Nancy. Are you there?
Yes.
Hi, how you doing today?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Wonderful. Thank you for calling in today. And what is your question?
I have a question. If I own my own piece of property or my own lot, does the builder, can he come and build on my own property?
Can you build, if she has a lot, can you help her?
Absolutely.
That's a good
Jenna,
question.
We do quite a bit of that. Matter of fact, that's more of what we do than anything else, is building on someone else's lot.
Okay.
Cool.
And custom builders will typically do that. So she's talking to the right person. If she wants to have a home built on her lot, a custom builder would be the right person to talk with.
Right. So you come in and you take care of the design, the engineering.
Yeah. My question would be then, if you do come out to the property, then do we sit down with an architect? Do you have someone to help design the home?
We actually do. We have a team of architects that we work with, not just one, and we try to pair our architect with the style of the home and the customer that we think fits best.
Right.
But we will literally sit down and do a lifestyle interview with our customer. We find out How many kids are in the family? Do they entertain? What are their hobbies? You know, what are their lifestyles? Do they have an older parent or an older child that lives with them? Might need to build an in-law suite on this home. There's a lot of that going on these
there
days.
There is, definitely.
So after we complete the lifestyle interview, we'll do a wish list. And
okay.
From the wish list, we start developing a set of plans uniquely for that buyer.
Perfect.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
So
okay.
How do people get in touch with you?
You know, the easiest way to reach us is to call our phone number, which is 469-305-0606, or they can visit us at northstarluxuryhomes.com.
Oh, wonderful.
Perfect. Okay. Well, that's one of my main things is how do I get started if I have property of my own and want to build something specifically for us. So that was very helpful. Thank you.
Thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Have a great day. Okay. So, that's what part of what you do. You come in and you take care of the design, the interior design. Now, I have a question about that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, sometimes I go into homes where you can tell that someone built the layout because it doesn't match all the other homes. It's not really a stand, you know, it's almost like having a door on top of the car or the steering wheel to the, does that make sense?
Something
it's not
unique,
standardized.
Different from what you've seen in other
Something
homes.
Unique, but not only unique, but almost like maybe a little uncomfortable because it's not normal. So mm-hmm. Do you help people, you know, to not put things in weird places sometimes?
Yeah, we do. I'm glad you brought that up, Jenna. We feel like one of our biggest jobs is to keep you, the home buyer, from making a mistake. And so
right. We
know the home building industry. Now, I'll build it. You ask me to build it, we'll build it for you.
But no matter what, right.
That's correct. But if we think it's a mistake, we'll tell you. We think that maybe you should do this a little differently or this
right. Might
not be the best way to do this. If you still tell us you want to put the door on the top, we'll do it that way.
Because it's your house
that's
and
correct.
You're paying.
You're paying for it.
Right.
We're building it for you. But, you know, there's a fence that we have to straddle in the luxury home building business or in the custom home building business. And that is to straddle the fence between doing something traditional, which every builder can do,
right. And
doing something unique without crossing over into the world of weird. So we don't want
right. It
to look weird.
Right.
So we try to give you, the home buyer, something unique. And every home we build, it's your home. We want it to be a representation of your personality.
Absolutely.
But we don't want it to do what you just said, look weird when someone walks in.
Right. But these the people, your buyer, your customer wants a unique home.
Absolutely.
That no one else has, that has the best of everything. They want the top.
That's
of everything,
correct.
I guarantee.
And that's why they come to us. You know, there's in the volume building world, the only way that a builder like Adrie's Homes, who builds a very good home, the only way that they can build at the price point they build is to do the same thing repetitively
exactly. Over
and over again. And that's a great business model.
Yes.
The custom home building model is completely different from that. We're building them one at a time. They're a unique one-off. Every home is different. So it's a longer process. It's a more expensive process. But at the end of the day, you've got something that was designed and built uniquely just for you. No one in the world has one like it.
Okay. I have so many questions just popping in my head.
Okay.
Okay. My next question, though, I've got to get this in. What if I'm a realtor and I have a client that is wanting to build a home? Would I come? Do you pay fees just like normal?
Oh, absolutely. We love realtors. We work with realtors. I teach courses for CCAR, for Metrotex, for the Greater Louisville Association of Realtors. We have a great relationship with realtors. And I understand as a custom home builder that about 60 or 70% of homes are sold with realtors involved.
Right.
So it's a community that I love to support. Realtors come to me and we're happy to pay them a commission just like we would if we already had a spec home on the ground ready to sell.
Okay. Well, that's good to know because I like getting commission, you know.
You bet. It's your
I like
livelihood.
Getting paid. And I am a realtor, everyone, so don't forget that. And if you are wanting to buy or sell your home, you can call me. And if you're interested in a home with a luxury home as well, you can give me a call and I will help you with that. Okay. So now let's talk about what is available in Frisco as far as lots are concerned for these luxury homes? What are people wanting? Are they wanting, you know, I get a lot of calls from people where they want, you know, certain views, golf course, but they want city septic. They don't want to have their own septic tank and things like that. So tell me mm-hmm. what about location.
Location is tough. We're in an environment right now where there aren't a lot of lots to choose from. We have a housing shortage, which also means we have a lot shortage.
Right.
And the prices are rising dramatically. But if you were to look in the Frisco area, you know, the lot prices, which have skyrocketed tremendously in the last 2 or 3 years. It's ridiculous.
No kidding. No kidding.
But you've got the Hills of Kingswood. Starwood still has a lot or two available. Really not much left there.
Right.
Newman Village has some product available and some lot choices. Not much to choose from there either. It's a subdivision's on fire, and there's not a whole lot left to choose from there.
Right.
Chapel Creek, which you may be familiar with, has a new phase that they've opened. There's some lots available there.
Good.
So I'd say the best area to go for choices in Frisco would probably be Chapel Creek and the Hills of Kingswood. More lot availability in those two than there are in the others.
Are they zero lot lines, or do they have anything nice about them?
They're huge lots. They're big lots. For city lots, they're considered
oversized.
I know,
but oversized. The home is going to be 7,000 square feet, so that's a big footprint.
It's a big footprint, so you need, a third or half an acre. You can go in Hills of Kingswood and get 1 acre lots in Hills of Kingswood. There's a few buyers in Hills of Kingswood who've combined lots together.
Ooh.
So they combine 2 3-quarter acre lots and have a beautiful estate 1.5 acre lot to build on.
Yeah, they come in from California and they're like looking at our houses and going, what?
Yep.
I can get all that.
All of that.
That's cheap. And it's so funny to see. Okay, so that's in Frisco. And so are you seeing, do you help people that are going like to Lovejoy and Lucas and any of that?
We do. We try to keep up with what's going on around our neighborhoods, which would be out in the Fairview area in the Lovejoy School District,
right.
and Lucas and out that way. We don't build a whole lot there because we are headquartered in Frisco. There's more demand in the Frisco area.
Okay.
But if someone wanted to move out into the Lovejoy School District, we would absolutely help them find a lot and build a home for them.
Okay, but you're really Frisco.
We really are.
And there's riches and niches, and it's good to have a niche like that. That's mm-hmm. an awesome niche.
Mm-hmm.
So what is your price? Where do you start?
That's a difficult question to answer because the size of the home, the size of the lot, the amenities, all of that will come into play. But I'd say that our final sales price with the lot, the home, the swimming pool, all of that, it right now is running somewhere between $230 and $260 a square foot.
Okay. Okay. 7,000 square feet.
Yeah. So you're looking at $1.6, $1.8 million.
Okay. Okay. So that's your average home
mm-hmm.
that you're building.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. 6,000 or 7,000. 5,000 to 7,000 square feet.
That's amazing. And then we were just talking before the show, we were talking about how, and remember when I had that show, everyone, it's on my website if you want to go and watch the rerun, but we were talking about Legacy West, and Legacy West is just booming, and they haven't even gotten started yet, and they're bringing 25,000 jobs, 30,000 jobs, and they're going to have a street of shops just for gentlemen. Just, gentlemen's clothing, and all these executives are coming. And so we're booming. The land is getting more expensive.
Mm-hmm.
The market is incredible. We, as much as we want to build houses, we can, as many as we can, as fast as we can. Would mm-hmm. you not say that's the case?
Oh, that's absolutely the goal. And we're way we're way behind.
That's what I mean. And yeah. And so when we get back from the break, I want to talk to y'all about the labor shortage. We have a break coming up, not now, but in just a minute we're going to talk about. But I don't want to get into that yet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so but you will go other places, but you don't even need to because you're staying plenty busy right there in Frisco.
We're pretty busy right in the Frisco area. We do build other places. We've got a project going in South Lake. We've got one going in Richardson. So we're happy to build other places.
Okay.
So anywhere that someone has a lot or wants to build, we'll be happy to help them with it.
Okay. What are some of the fun things that people are wanting in their homes nowadays?
Oh, my goodness. We live in an area in an age now where the normal is not normal anymore. People can get and want all kinds of crazy things.
Oh.
So are you talking about from a style perspective or?
I don't know. Just what pops in your mind when I say that people want?
Well, I'd say probably from a design perspective, the biggest thing that I see happening from a design perspective is the in-law suite.
Suite.
A lot of people are wanting that. And
I see that a lot.
A second office.
A second office. Well, heck yeah.
Yeah.
We've got two,
two parents both working from home.
That's true.
Yes.
That's true.
We're seeing quite a bit of that. And then, it's been a strategy that we've been doing for quite some time is we put our media rooms on the first floor.
Now, I sold a house like that in Gentle Creek
mm-hmm.
in Prosper,
mm-hmm.
Gentle Creek Golf Course. It was the most gorgeous home, and it had a media room downstairs and so convenient.
Yeah, when you put it upstairs, it becomes a second playroom for the children. When you put it downstairs, it's more convenient to finish your dinner, have a little bit of wine, and then, hey, let's pop into the media room and watch a movie.
Perfect, perfect. Sounds awesome. You guys, we're going to break. Talk to you in a minute.
Are you ready to take advantage of this hot Dallas real estate market? If so, go to my website at imaysell.com. Fill out the form and receive valuable information about selling your home. The Dallas real estate market is hotter than ever. We're having the biggest real estate boom in 10 years. Maybe it's time for you to sell your home. If so, visit imaysell.com. That's imaysell.com. Fill out the form and receive valuable information about selling your home in the Dallas, Denton, and Collin counties.
I know I need to earn my MBA if I want to move up. I'm looking for an MBA that offers unique concentrations. I want an online MBA that's top-ranked, established. I care about the school's reputation because I know my future employers will, too.
Thinking about earning your MBA? At Northeastern's DeMoor McKim School of Business, we offer a 100% online MBA with 8 concentrations that can help set you apart in today's competitive workforce.
To speak to an enrollment advisor, text WORK to 37913.
Hey there, and good morning. From the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer Weather Center, I'm Will Shotwell with a look at your DFW forecast. Showers today and a high around 66, then tonight more showers and a low around 60. This report's brought to you by the TJ Martell Foundation.
Hey everybody, I'm Eric Church, asking you to join me in the fight against leukemia, cancer, and AIDS through the TJ Martell Foundation. Your support helps facilitate cutting-edge research that will lead to more effective treatments and save more lives. Visit tjmartell.org to learn about music's promise for a cure.
The phone lines are open at 214-787-1190. Here's Jenna Ryan.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the show. We're having a great time this Sunday afternoon. I'm here today with Barry Hensley of North Star Luxury Homes in Frisco and Phil Crone with the Dallas Builder Association. And we are really getting into some great, great information here. And it's just an interesting conversation all the way around. Our phone lines are open. You guys can call us at 214-787-1190. I want to hear your voice. I want to hear from you. If you have any questions for us, if you want to ask a question about the Dallas-Fort Worth building market, we've got these brains in here right now, and we're ready to answer the questions. The next topic we're going to go on to is we're going to talk about one of the major problems, I think, other than the regulatory issues. I think one of the major problems for home builders would be the labor shortage I'm hearing about.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we were talking before the break about just some of the demand that we've seen in areas like Frisco and Prosper and talking about the lot shortage. Well, we also have a labor shortage that I think is the biggest challenge that's facing the builders right now. We did a survey a little while back, and we asked our builders, hey, how long is this delaying you? How much is it costing you? And they said at a minimum, it's delaying delivery of new homes by 2 months and costing about $4,000.
Wow.
And it's both skilled and unskilled labor. So it's anywhere from the licensed trades like plumbers and electricians all the way over to the framing and roofing contractors. And Barry, I'm sure you're seeing it. I'm sure you could give us some examples of just what you're dealing with on your job sites right now.
Yeah, it's had a dramatic impact on our project scheduling. That's the toughest part of it. Because, and I'll give you a good example. In the custom home building world, there's a lot of changes, as you expect. We're dealing with a home buyer. They'll come along and make a change.
Oh, yeah.
And the example I like to use is, let's suppose that we put some tile down for the kitchen area. And the customer's been maybe contemplating putting wood in there, and they've thought about it for a while. And after we put the tile in, they change their mind and say, you know what, I've changed my mind, I want to put wood in there. And normally that would be a 3-day process. We'd rip out the tile, and we'd put the wood back in, and we'd keep the process moving.
Wow.
But in today's world, we have to call the tile guy back to rip the tile out, and he's busy on another job, so that takes a week. Then we have to call the wood guy back to get the wood, and he's busy on another job, so that takes 2 weeks. And then after all that process is done, what would normally take 2 or 3 days winds up taking 3 or 4 weeks. Then we have to reschedule everyone else who was supposed to work after that. So we risk just one small delay like that risks being a 5 or 6 week delay on a project.
Well, so why? why do we have a labor shortage?
There's a lot of factors, and this is something it's not a new phenomenon. Certainly with the supply and demand and the increase in demand that we've had, since the recession especially, that has played a big factor. But I think it's deeper than that. It's actually a cultural shift. I mean, think about our grandparents' generation and think about the greatest generation. And America used to pride ourselves on manufacturing things, and we won wars that way, and everybody had a trade, and everybody had some sort of craft that they practiced it. But since then, we've moved to a service-based economy.
Yeah.
And a lot of things out there where success is supposedly defined by going to a 4-year school, getting whatever degree, and even if you end up being a nothing against Starbucks, I love it, but if you end up being a barista after that, it doesn't matter because it's that degree. Well, there are a lot of jobs in the construction industry that aren't being filled, and you've seen a lot of programs like just shop class and vocational type of programs that they're in my high school. They were probably in a lot of the people that are listening right now and in their high school, but those don't exist in schools anymore. And unfortunately, we're looking at probably about 300,000 jobs that need to be filled today, and that could approach a million if we don't do something about that in the next 6 or 7 years, according to the numbers we're looking at just in Texas.
President Trump, are you listening?
Yeah, that's if he was listening right now, what I would tell him is that we have, in all this talk about bringing manufacturing jobs from overseas back here,
right?
We need to talk a lot more about the manufacturing jobs that are already here that need to be filled either through these vocational programs or, you know, as a matter of fact, just with some of our immigrant labor that the construction industry relies heavily on. They need to make sure that there's a good pathway for them to work legally because these jobs are available.
That's very true. Mm-hmm. That is very true. Absolutely. So very interesting. So it's hard to get a house completed whenever you don't have the labor.
We looked at, you know, if you go back and look at the numbers in 2005, 2006, we built a lot of houses in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, around 30,000 a year.
Okay.
And the average time to complete the average size home was about 5.5 months.
Now, what year?
2005, 2006.
Okay.
You know, we experienced quite a bit of a boom then, and somebody could reasonably expect—
5 to 6 months.
Yeah, could reasonably expect their home to be done within 6 months. Today, that number is 11.4 months.
I know.
And it's all related to the labor shortage. So it's having a dramatic impact. We can't catch up. We're actually falling farther behind. That's the interesting statistic, is that the demand continues to outpace the supply. So the gap is getting wider every year. So we really, really, really need to train more people and have them available to work for us.
So it's also status. People don't want to be blue collar, maybe, you know, and that's seen more as blue collar.
Yeah, and I think that's part of that cultural shift that needs to happen, because I know me personally, I'm still carrying a heck of a lot in terms of student loans, and I know there are a lot of people in the 20 and 30 something generation that are, and these shop class and vocational type of programs, we have all the stats in the world to show what kind of great career path that's going to end up being for you. It just has to come back into vogue again.
Well, so maybe they don't pay as much. Maybe that's why. Because do they?
A plumber.
A plumber.
5 years on the job can easily knock down $75,000, $80,000 a year. That's a pretty good paying job.
That is a good paying job.
And the interesting thing out there is the plumbers, and you talk about the skilled trades, the average age of a plumber in the state of Texas is 57 years old right now.
Believe me, I know. I can't find a plumber. It's hard for me to find a plumber.
Yeah, nothing against anyone.
A week later.
Yeah, nothing against anybody that age, but someone who's 57 years old doesn't want to be a plumber for much longer. So if we don't start filling the pipeline again, it's definitely going to get worse.
Well, there's roofers everywhere. I mean, I put a thing on Facebook. I needed a roofer, and I got like 100 replies of roofers. So there's roofers everywhere because maybe it's not as regulated. Maybe they need to loosen up the qualifications of being a plumber.
It does take licensing. That's true. And roofing does not.
It takes hard. It must be difficult because you can't just get a plumber license. But of course, you want to make sure somebody's licensed.
Yeah, I mean, there are definitely a lot of roofers out there, and some talk, justified out there as far as the licensing of that industry. But I think every single roofing contractor would tell you we're understaffed and we don't have enough people on our site. So typically, what'll happen, and I'm sure Barry, you've experienced this quite a bit, is you have what should be a 12-person crew that comes out there, and you're lucky to get 4 or 5 people on there. And, of course, that's going to take double the amount of time, and that's a big cost for you and a big frustration for your homeowner
that's
as other
exactly
plans.
Right.
Well, if you ever need a roofer, I have so many roofers. Now, every day, I put that on Facebook one day, and I'm telling you, every day I get, do you need a roofer? It's like, no, we put the roof on. So if you ever need a roofer, I've got roofing connections.
Good. That's
I can
good
help
to know.
You with that. Okay, wonderful. So let's talk more about the things that are trendy in the homes. What about the smart homes? Are people wanting any smart stuff going on in their home?
Absolutely. And if you survey people, because Phil and I both keep up with all the statistics from the National Association of Home Builders, which does a great job providing us with statistics.
Right.
But they're going to put security at the top of their list.
Security.
So you want an alarm system. You want to protect your premises.
Yes.
And then it's going to trickle down from there into things like home entertainment and video surveillance and those things. And we see customers when you ask them, you know, right, would you like to have this in your home? It's in the 70% and 80% range that people do want to have that in their home. Not all the builders are offering that, but that's definitely a trend that we see coming, and the price of that is falling dramatically. So the homes of the future, okay, are all going to be equipped with all these smart devices.
Smart devices being, you know, video surveillance. I'm really careful when I go in anyone's home. I'm a realtor. You know, I tell my clients, don't say anything negative because they're probably watching, you know. So because there's videos everywhere,
you know,
and people have video, and you can just kind of tell.
It's interesting. Going to the International Builders Show is always a great place to go. It was in Orlando this past January, and
yeah,
there's a lot of talk, and it works certainly into the home, about the Internet of Things, and that's basically stuff that's connected to the Internet, and you can pretty much connect anything to the Internet. So I saw the difference between the Internet of Things, the security systems, and the things people want, and then what I'd call the Internet on Things, which is like a TV set in your refrigerator and all that
goodness.
Stuff there. Some
Seriously?
People want that just for a conversation piece. Maybe not the best investment, but there are things that for the more tech-oriented people, you could see and check in from anywhere in the world how well your hot water heater is behaving. And
oh,
be
my
able
goodness.
To control
and some
that
people
based
really
on your
are
lifestyle.
Interested in those things. The engineer-type people are very, very mm-hmm. careful and watch all of that information. That is so interesting. Okay, I've got this little gadget, and it has nothing to do with home building, but it does have to do with the home. And I love it. It's a trash can where I just wave my hand, and it opens. And I feel like the Jetsons. I feel so powerful when that happens. Do y'all have anything that's like automatic going on?
Well, if you put a For instance, if you put a central vac system in your home, which I don't know if you're familiar with that.
I am.
You can put these little collectors that go in the base plate under the cabinets. So when you're sweeping your floor, you just sweep it towards it and it sucks it up automatically. So
I would love
little things like that. And then the voice automation is becoming very, very, very popular. You know, Alexa and OK Google talking to your home. So you just say, Alexa, turn on, you know, television station, whatever, or tune in the Jenna Ryan Show. And it just tunes it in just like that.
That gives you a feeling of power and it really feels good, especially for your level of homes where, you know, you have a lot of powerful people purchasing.
We deal with a lot of sophisticated buyers.
Absolutely. And you can just put in all that smart stuff. That is so interesting.
Yeah, but even on a more practical level, Samsung's got a new line of smart appliances coming out. And all the manufacturers do. They're all following suit. But if your child opens the refrigerator and gets a juice bottle out and then they forget to close the refrigerator door, it'll send you a text and say you left your refrigerator door open.
Oh, my goodness.
So on a more
goodness.
Practical level, there is a lot of need for this technology.
That was the interesting thing about the Builder Show. Since they combined it with the Kitchen and Bath Show, you get the best of the Kohlers and the Moens and the Deltas and everybody else. So almost all of them had some sort of shower head, or I wouldn't even call it a shower head. These are shower stalls now. So it's almost like you could put it's like what they wash the zoo elephants with or something. But you can be able to time out all of the different shower heads and everything in the stall to whatever music you're playing. And that was extremely interesting. I think they even have a little recording studio for those of you that like to sing in the shower. They had that on display there too. So it's just, again, Internet of Things versus Internet on Things. I mean, anything is possible. Barry will put all that stuff in your home if you want it. And some of it's a novelty. Some of it's a necessity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And now I heard that Bill Gates has like the art that changes when you go in the room. We're not there yet.
The technology's there.
The technology is there.
Yes, it is. I can identify you when you walk in a room. When two or three people walk into a room, I can identify who those people are.
Okay.
So if I set the priority in the home automation system to say, when Jenna walks in this room, turn the lights to this, turn the music to this, turn the artwork to this, we can do all of that. So the technology is there. Some of it's still pretty expensive, but again, the price is dropping dramatically. So when you get ready to build your home and you want some of that, we can absolutely build it for you.
Absolutely. I don't know if I could. Yeah. Anyway.
It's a little big brother. Kind of seems a little big brother at times. But it's really neat stuff.
Well, my car, it drives me crazy when it goes ding, ding, ding. It's like it tells me what to do.
It thinks for you.
It's starting to get like, you know, big brother. It really feels like it. It's like, okay, I don't want to do that right now. Mm-hmm. And hopefully our homes won't get like that where they're like, you know, close the door. Now, I've been in homes that do that, you know, they beep every time really loudly
every time
you open
door
and close.
Every time a door or window is opened. Yeah.
And you feel more secure. Some people would feel more secure with that kind of option.
Mm-hmm.
Very interesting. You guys, our phone lines are open. We're talking about smart houses. When we get back from our break, I want to talk about design, what people are wanting in design, and exterior.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll be right back.
Well, there's a black man with a black cat.
Hi, can I have two steak tacos?
Flour or corn?
Oh, no tortillas. And no steak. Also add turkey, lettuce, and tomato. And just put it between two slices of bread.
You know this is a taco truck, right?
As a small business owner, you've got enough to deal with. Let the experts at Progressive insure your business so you can focus on whatever that was. With over 30 commercial, auto, and business coverage options, we'll build a plan that's right for you.
Oh, I'll have Swiss on that too. Thank you.
Visit ProgressiveCommercial.com to get started. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Are you considering a mortgage loan? If so, contact my favorite lender, Brad Walters, with American Southwest Lending. He's always available and always on time. He's the only guy I would consider for all of my clients' loans. He's direct and to the point and doesn't give you the runaround. Call Brad Walters with American Southwest Lending at 214-924-1066. He will get the best rate and the best loan for you.
Hey there, and good morning. From the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer Weather Center, I'm Will Shotwell with a look at your DFW forecast. Showers today in a high around 66, then tonight more showers and a low around 60. This report's brought to you by the TJ Martell Foundation.
Hey everybody, I'm Eric Church, asking you to join me in the fight against leukemia, cancer, and AIDS through the TJ Martell Foundation. Your support helps facilitate cutting-edge research that will lead to more effective treatments and save more lives. Visit tjmartell.org to learn about music's promise for a cure.
Welcome back to the Jenna Ryan Show on Talk Radio 1190 AM.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the show. I'm over here banging my head to my music. Y'all like my music? My show intro. Thank you, Ron Taylor, for that. That was really good. Awesome. Okay, I'm here today with Barry Hensley with North Star Luxury Homes in Frisco and Phil Crone with the Dallas Builders Association. And we are talking about new homes, new construction. And we were getting into a great conversation about technology. And now we're going to talk about design. If you guys have any questions for these fabulous individuals, give us a call at 214-787-1190. And let's just get right into this. I want to know, okay, first of all, I want to know, I've seen this trend, especially down in Dallas, Preston Hollow, that those real modern looking homes. Are you getting any requests for that in Frisco?
So as a builder, yes, we are definitely getting requests for that.
Okay.
The biggest challenge I have in Frisco in the suburbs is the deed restrictions. They typically will not allow us to build a home like that, which is why you see more of it down in the Preston Hollow area, because they don't have deed restrictions that prevent that. But that style of home is definitely in demand. No question.
It is in high demand. And they do have that new home builder. Who's that new? I think it's called. Do you know that?
You're talking about Mainview?
Mainview, thank you. Mm-hmm. Mainview Homes, which is, you know, it's off the standard track.
Yeah, definitely. They're kind of inspired, and they saw the demand that Barry was talking about in town in the Dallas area. And to the extent they can in the suburbs, because they run into a lot of the same regulations, they took a very popular style that actually it's an Australian company. They have some roots in the Pacific Northwest in Seattle, and they've delivered here to Texas. And I think have done a pretty good job satisfying that market, again, to the extent they can in Frisco and the McKinney area. But really, the modern stuff is a trend that's not going anywhere. We have a number of builders in our association that specialize in it at the higher end of the custom market.
So that will that will streamline even more into the future. Why is Frisco not allowing that?
There's a lot of, and the prevailing mentality is, and it's kind of interesting dealing with, Frisco's not as bad about it as folks like Prosper are, but there are philosophies among the founding fathers or the city leaders there that just, it almost turns a city council with some of their design requirements into an HOA, and then plus you have, of course, developer-established HOAs all over the place. So on one hand, they don't want the monotony, but on the other hand, they don't want something that doesn't really look like everything else up there, even if the demand is there.
So they want everything to look cookie-cutter.
They do, but they don't. It's interesting.
They can't decide.
You have to remember that your suburbs are dominated by volume builders. Volume builders build a product that has to have mass appeal.
Right.
So they want their product to fit within a nice, tidy little box.
Okay.
And that's a good business model.
Yes, it is.
But to get outside of that, mm-hmm. you have to get into an area like North Dallas and the Preston Hollow area where you can build something that's not cookie cutter.
Right.
Or get into a subdivision that allows it. And typically the subdivisions have very tight deed restrictions and won't allow some of those modern styles.
Understood. So what are you able to do for a buyer?
Well, we can push the envelope to some extent, primarily on the interior of the home.
Okay.
On the exterior, we're seeing some design trend changes on the exterior. You may remember that windows typically have dividers in them. The little divides the windows into little squares.
Yes.
The buyers want those gone. Now, so we're able to do that.
The buyers do not. They want just the flat look.
They want
the modern
windows,
look.
The more modern look. That's
okay,
correct.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, but flat roofs, we can't do that. Those things are out. You know, so some of the design elements we're able to bring in, some that we're not. Now, in the interior of the home, the deed restrictions don't go past the front door, so we can do whatever we want on the inside. And that's where we're seeing a lot of design changes are on the inside of the home.
Interesting.
Much more contemporary.
Much more contemporary throughout.
Yes.
And what is the material they like for their kitchen cabinets and color?
Okay, so it's high contrast.
Not cabinets. I mean, sorry. Yeah,
the finish?
Go. Whatever you were going to say. That was good.
Yeah,
high contrast.
So it's high contrast. So we're seeing blacks and whites. The color palette has moved, as you've seen in the last 5 or 6 years. The color palette has moved from a warm to a cool color palette.
Okay.
So now we're seeing kind of a neutral to cool, which are your blacks, your blues, your grays, your whites.
My living room is gray, yes.
There you go.
And they like the white cabinets.
White cabinets, white countertops or dark countertops, high contrast, so blacks and whites mixed together. We're seeing a lot of that in the homes. But then if you just do that, if you just move to the cool color palette where you're sticking within the blacks, the whites, the blues, the grays, you have to warm that up with something.
Okay.
So we're seeing a little bit of a blend of the rustic comes back in with the hardwood floors or a barn door or a wall with barn wood on it, something that warms the space up a little bit.
Okay, because you've got, and the, oh, I could just see that now, the black, the white, the windows, and the Viking, you know, gas range, and I could just see it. It sounds beautiful. Even like, are they doing any of the black trim?
Absolutely.
Oh, that's so beautiful.
It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous.
So beautiful. Yeah. So are they doing white cabinets?
White cabinets is the predominant cabinet style. And Jenna, we live in a very small world now because of things like Pinterest and Houzz.
Uh-huh.
People can now look and see what's going on in the rest of the world. So we're seeing a lot of those design elements being brought into the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
Yes, and I walk into people's homes. I'm like, somebody loves Pinterest. I can just tell.
You can tell.
I can absolutely tell. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now what is the material? Granite is everywhere everywhere. But what about your market?
Okay, so we're almost 100% quartz.
That white quartz.
It's beautiful.
It's so gorgeous.
Yeah.
And is there any other – someone was talking about another one, and I can't remember.
Well, you're still seeing some concrete, not a whole lot of it, but you can get countertops in whatever finish you want. We're even seeing some of the woods come back into play, some wood countertops.
Okay.
But the primary thing that we see in the custom building market is the quartz.
I would go with quartz all the way.
Absolutely.
And then they're doing crisp white walls.
Mm-hmm.
Is that – pretty standard. So what you're saying is they're going with the high contrast blacks and whites, but then they're adding an element of warmth with a rustic look rather than making the walls, brown or that tanny. The tan color or beige, whatever that beige color was, is not so popular anymore. I mean, you still see it a lot because a lot of people was popular. But now it's the white. If I understand correctly, are you getting a lot of that?
Whites and grays on
whites
the walls.
Whites and grays.
Yep, no question about it. Even some of the darker grays, like for an accent wall or a room that you may want to paint with a darker gray.
Right.
But yes, the beiges, the browns, they're primarily gone.
Okay, yes. So if you build a home, you want to build a home that is going to stay up with the times, and you want to make sure that the things that you get in the home are fit for the future.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now what about, I want to ask you, Phil, about aging in place. That was really on your website, about aging in place. And what does that mean?
Definitely. So aging in place means being able to stay in your home as your needs change. And usually that means accessibility type of changes. We have a certified aging in place specialist, national designation. It's one of the most popular that we offer at the Dallas Builders Association, and of course that stands for CAPS. And a lot of these remodels, and it's interesting, kind of pulling back into the Operation Finally Home thing, we're looking at doing some remodeling projects for veterans, and really it's widening doorways, it's grab bars in the bathroom, it's taking care of those thresholds so you can roll right into the shower, some of these things that just allow people to, as they get older, avoid some of the common hazards, most of which involve falls that can really be hazardous, of course, to elderly folks.
Okay, so aging in place is the process of getting a home ready for a senior person.
Definitely, and that's a lot of people, they, of course, love where they live. They've been in their house for a long time. Maybe they've paid off the note on there, and they want to stay, and they just need some changes made so the home can evolve with their needs.
Well, that is awesome. Okay, so wonderful. So tell me more about your company, about how it works.
Well,
how many people do you have in your office?
We have three.
You have three people in your office, but you have a bunch of people that are like engineers and
we do. We
have designers.
Yes, and they don't work for us. They're contractors. They're subcontracted to us. So, yes.
Okay.
Interior designers, home designers, engineers, structural engineers, foundation engineers. And then, of course, all the trades that come in, which from foundation to roof and everything in between is what we hire out
right.
to build the homes for us. And a lot of what we use are specialty contractors that worked only in custom homes because they have to be able to think outside the box just like we do as a builder.
Right.
So we employ all of those specialized trades to work with us, but we're a very dedicated team. So when we work for a customer, we're spending a good bit of our time with that customer because we'll build five or six homes in a year.
Okay.
And we're spending all of our time on just those projects as opposed to a volume builder who may build 400 homes a year.
Okay. So this is a high customer service.
Yes.
Like they get exquisite customer service where they get all, you know, if they need to make a change last minute, they get a change at
the
last minute.
Absolutely.
And that's part of what they're paying for.
That's exactly
is
what
that
paying
service
for.
Because everything's custom and everything, you know, it's perfect for what they choose. And so that's very awesome.
Yeah. And it takes a lot of input from a customer. You know, I have to know who you are. I have to know what your lifestyle is. I have to know what your likes and dislikes are. And we have a whole world of products to choose from. We're not going to give you three tiles and say pick level one, level two, level three. We're going to give you the world.
Oh,
say,
my goodness.
So, yes, we have to have a lot of communication, a lot of interaction.
Where do you go? Do you send them to a design center?
We send them to several different design centers.
Holy mackerel.
Yeah,
I can imagine.
There's a lot to choose from. And then, of course, your computer screen, you got the whole world at your fingertips. And so
you just say, I want something that looks like this.
Exactly.
And so it takes about 11 months mm-hmm. to build the home from the beginning to the end. Mm-hmm. And that you can call me if you want a lot. Well, would they call? You do the lot, too.
We will help our buyers find a lot. I recommend that they work with, if they want to work with a realtor, which is probably a smart thing to do.
Yes.
I recommend that they work with a realtor that services that area.
Absolutely.
Because just like in your business, you've got areas of town that you know better than others.
Mm-hmm.
So if someone wants a lot in Frisco or in Prosper, or out
in the I specialize in Frisco.
Then I recommend they call you, Jenna.
Yes. Yes,
great.
Call me. I'm there every day. Actually, I have an open house today in Frisco. Y'all should come see me at the open house at Hunter's Creek. And it's from 1 to 3. Because I'm a realtor. Mm-hmm. I sell houses around here. And so, yeah, well, that's so interesting. I love learning more about the home builder market and the associations that we have out here. That's awesome. Okay, well, you guys, thank you for listening this week. We have a great show coming up next week with Angela Dean. And we have financial planners coming up and foundation people. So you guys listen next week and throughout the year. And it's good to see you. And I will hear from you next. Give us a call or come and see me. Come and see me on my website at JennaRyanRealty.com or follow me on Facebook at Jenna.Ryan1. And that's it.
Well, there's a black man with black hair.
You've been listening to The Jenna Ryan Show on Talk Radio 1190 AM.
For more information, contact Jenna through Facebook or email at jennaryanrealty@gmail.com. Join us again next time on Talk Radio 1190 AM for The Jenna Ryan Show. 1190 AM. For more information, contact Jenna through Facebook or email at jennaryanrealty@gmail.com. Join us again next time on Talk Radio 1190 AM for The Jenna Ryan Show.